নমস্কার, কেমন আছেন আপনারা? আজকে আপনাদের এখানে এসে আমার খুব ভালো লাগছে। I'm very, very pleased to be with you all here in Shillong, in general, to see this wonderful, thriving community, particularly many who have moved here from Bengal. Bengal has been my second home in my childhood, so I feel particularly pleased to come and connect to all of you. Ajano Nigoshi Shubhalak. I've come to ask you to support our Congress candidate, Mr. Simcoe, who you are going to see and hear from shortly. But I do so for one very important reason. Even though the previous MLA was unable to offer her candidacy this time, you know that she has done outstanding work for all of you in this constituency. There you are, that's the reaction. Her efforts as part of one of the most effective state governments in the country have helped restore this state and this part of Shillong to normalcy, to communal harmony, to peace and visible prosperity. It's remarkable that you were able to celebrate Puja last year with great fanfare because the Congress government and the local MLA were able to ensure an atmosphere of peace. Now, we find that tribals and non-tribals alike can move around the state freely and without anxiety. Tourism, as a result, has been boosted. Hotels are full. Restaurants, homestays are all attracting large numbers of visitors. The roads have been improved. The aqueducts are flowing again. And your MLA did an enormous amount of work in this constituency. Some of it is visible right here. Right nearby we have the Bongia Shohitya Parishad, whose renovation work has been done. The new community hall that is being built with the MLA scheme and the CM's fund. The supermarket in Polo, it was just a slum. And now, thanks to the MLA and the government spending 20 crores, you have a beautiful and clean supermarket area. So all of this is happening here. And in the state at large, Congress has been able to deliver good governance in Meghalaya. You have to be proud of your state. Look at your health. It's astonishing to see that when the central government in its budget this year proposed a health insurance scheme, they were merely offering a pay limitation of what Meghalaya has already offered its people for the last 3 years. Under Dr. Mukul Sangma, a medical practitioner himself, you have the mega health insurance scheme under which every family for a nominal premium of 500 rupees can get 2,800,000 rupees of coverage for hospitalization and more for those below the poverty line. That's the kind of example that you should set. What has happened in Delhi? They have come up with a scheme which they can't even find the funding for. It is not even a match for what you already enjoy in Meghalaya. You are all urban dwellers and have talked about the changes in your constituency. But out in the rural areas, we are seeing the integrated development and land and livelihood scheme, the integrated basic development and livelihood scheme, which is transforming the livelihoods of people in the rural areas. And last year, just to take a fourth and last example, the Meghalaya government became the first in the country to pass a social audit law. And that law gives you, the citizens of Meghalaya, the right to demand an audit to see whether the beneficiaries of any government program are receiving the benefits they should be receiving. This is amazing. It's a step to towards greater accountability, greater transparency, greater steps to ensure that your government works for you, works for those it is intended to help, and not for any wrong or corrupt purpose. Doesn't this government deserve re-election? I believe so. What are the alternatives? On the one hand, we have the BJP. The Prime Minister came yesterday making a new round of promises. He is wonderful at making speeches and promises. He is less wonderful at fulfilling them. In Delhi, they have been in power for 3 years and three quarters of a year. Achhe Din are still far away, still elusive. Instead, what we have is one disaster after another. Demonetization, a bad idea, badly implemented. GST, a good idea, badly implemented. Nothing seems to work except bad implementation. As a result, people have been thrown out of work. Daily wage workers have lost their jobs. Micro and small enterprises are shutting down. Our economy is stagnating. Our agriculture in such distress that farmers are committing suicide in larger and larger numbers. What is to happen now to the future of our country? How long can we believe promises that are never fulfilled? I ask the people of Meghalaya, does the BJP represent an idea of India that you would be comfortable with? You who are used to living with people of all religions, all faiths, all castes, all tribes, all colors, do you want an India where in Meghalaya they come and tell you you can eat anything including beef? And elsewhere in India, they beat people, they even assault and murder people on suspicion of eating beef. Do you want to believe promises that they will respect people of all faiths when we know that in different parts of India we have had people of different faiths assaulted in the most terrible way? Can we believe that they respect the equality of all Indians, of every community, caste and creed, when we have seen the way they treat minorities in different parts of the country? And can we trust them on good governance? I asked the housewife who paid 390 rupees for a cooking gas cylinder under the UPA and who is paying over 700 rupees today, is she happy with the deal with these promises? I asked the young man who takes his scooter to the petrol pump at a time when world prices of petrol and diesel have been crashing, and he is paying more for his petrol and diesel in India than any of the neighboring countries because his government is trying to meet its fiscal deficit targets by putting their hands into the pockets of the armed army. I ask you, is that fair? Is that the promise you want to believe? I ask the young people who have promised jobs in Mr. Modi's great speeches 4 years ago. He said, I will give you 2 crore jobs a year. I asked those young people, have you got the jobs? The government's own figures show they've created barely a lakh of jobs a year. Not even 1% of the promise has been fulfilled. How will this country move forward? They promised you a temple in Ayodhya. Yes, we all love Ram, but what about Kaam? Give us work, silly young people. So I say to you all, the BJP has no answers for the people of Meghalaya. Don't believe their promises. They have not fulfilled their promises anywhere. Why would they fulfill them here? And then you look at the regional parties. What do we find with the regional parties? The big one in this state seems to be the NPP. But the NPP pretends to be an independent party here, but everywhere else they are the tail of the big dog called the BJP. Everywhere else are allied to the BJP. Why do they pretend to be independent here? Because they are seeking your votes as local heroes. I'm sorry to say, once they get your votes, they will attach themselves to the big dog and they will wag the tail when they are commanded to. Is that what you want? Only the Congress Party can form a government that brings you stability. as you've seen in the state for the last 8 years. The regional parties, you know, will never be able to form the government alone. Many of them have not even fielded candidates across the state in all 60 constituencies. So they will come, they will beg for your vote during the elections, but after that, you will be on your own. Don't trust them. Come back to the Congress Party. Support the Congress Party, because the Congress Party will fulfill its promises as it has done for the last 8 years. In Mr. Simcon, we have a candidate who will continue the fine work of his great predecessor, Mrs. Marjorie. And he will promise to help you there. So all I want to say is, Ami apna deke anurodh korchi ki apnara apnar bhogmulya vote diye Congress candidate ke joy jukto korun. Vote for Congress!